Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to level the heater bed of your Orca2 Cygnus with auto leveling. The first thing to do is adjust the distance between the extruder and heater bed. To do that, you need to measure the height of the two Z rods and see if they're as high as each other. A ruler will be very helpful here, and be sure the printer is off. Put the ruler through here, measure the height of the right rod, and write down the reading. It's 13.5 on the right. Okay, then move to the left. It's 13, so the right rod is 0.5cm higher than the left. This will cause a problem when you are leveling the bed. You can turn the left rod clockwise to lift it, and make it as high as the right rod. Now turn on the printer. Home all the axes. Check the distance between the nozzle and the heater bed. The ideal distance should be based on the actual situation, but it's around 0.1mm. To make it easier, I'll show you a little trick. You can use a thing as thick as a business card to help you. What I'm going to do here is try to put the card between the nozzle and the bed. In the ideal situation, you can put it between them with a little strength. When the nozzle moves on it, you can hear a slight scrape. If the distance is too wide, you can put the card through without any friction with the nozzle. Actually, you can see from this angle that the nozzle is too high above the bed. What you need to do is turn the thumb nut anti-clockwise to lower the position where the D-end stop is triggered. Then you need to lift the Z-axis a little bit and lower it to trigger the end stop. You can choose how many millimeters it moves by one click here. You'll hear beeps here when you do it. Check again the distance between the nozzle and the heater bed. If it's still a little too wide, you may repeat the thumb nut turning process until the nozzle reaches the correct position. If the distance is too narrow, you'll not be able to put the card between the nozzle and the bed. What you're going to do is turn the thumb nut clockwise to lift the position where the end stop is triggered. The rest of steps are quite the same. Okay, now the trickiest part is over. Lift the Z-axis, put on the auto-leveling sensor, and then run the auto-leveling process. After it's done, take off the sensor and heat up the extruder. Be ready for a test print of the model you want to print. Now, load the filament. Observe the extrusion and make sure the filament sticks to the bed. In most cases, the filament will stick well and you can start the print directly. But if the nozzle is too far away from the bed, the filament isn't able to stick to the bed. or is too close to the bed, the filament won't be able to come out or stick well. You need to go back to the sauna at any step. Now the tutorial is all over. Thank you for watching. If you still have any questions about auto leveling, please email our support team. We will be happy to help you.